Hello, Internet. Today, I'm going to show you how to make your own SuzyQable, or however you want to pronounce it. This one here is one that's manufactured by SparkFun, and it works great. The only thing is that their website shows the product is retired. I don't think they did this intentionally. I think it's just due to the global supply chain shortages that are happening right now. And fortunately though, we can get more of them simply by making our own. So the Chromium OS project has published on their website the schematics for the cable. It's actually just a couple of resistors and connecting the wires some different ways, and you'll have your own SuzyQable. So what you're going to need for this project is a USB-C breakout board with a male connector on the end. And this just breaks out all the different pins that we're going to need to connect to. You'll also need two resistors, a 22 kilo ohm resistor and a 56 kilo ohm resistor. And finally, you're going to need a donor USB cable. This one's just a micro USB cable. Anything with the standard USB-A connector should work for this project. The tools you're going to need are solder, soldering iron. You'll also want a pair of scissors. So without further ado, let's get started. We're going to first put the 22 kilo ohm resistor between V-bus and the A5 pin, which is CC1. So since we need to connect all of the V-bus pins together, I'm just going to bend this leg of the resistor over to the next nearest V-bus pin and use the leg of the resistor as a jumper. So here I am connecting pin A4 to B9. So what I've done here is I've taken the 22 kilo ohm resistor. I connected pins A4 and A5 together between the resistor. And then I took the extra leg of the resistor and bridged pins A5 and B9. Next, we're going to install the 56 kilo ohm resistor. The 56 kilo ohm resistor goes between pins B5, which is CC2, and V-bus. So let's find B5 here, which is labeled as VCON on my breakout board. And it needs to connect to V-bus. So very much similarly, I'm gonna bend this around and through. Similar to what we did with the 22 kilo ohm resistor, I'm going to find the closest V-bus and bridge to it. This is simply just since all four V-bus pins need joined together. So I'm bridging pin B4 to pin A9. so now what we have is we have the 56 kilo ohm resistor connecting pins B4 and B5. And that's joined to the other V-bus connector on pin A9. So next what we want to do is actually rather simple. We're going to take our donor USB cable and donate it. And so I'm just going to strip a little bit of the housing here so that we have some wire to work with. All right, so you notice inside the wire, there are going to be four wires. There should be black, which is ground, red, which is positive 5 volts. We have white, which is data plus, and green, which is data minus. We want to connect red, which is 5 volts, to our V bus. We want to connect black to all four ground pins on the connector. We want to connect white, which is data plus, to pin A8, which is the side channel band number one. And we want to connect the green wire, which is D minus, to pin B8, which is the sideband usage wire number two. All right, so that's all there is to it. I have my cable put together. Let's go ahead and test this cable and see how it works compared to the commercially purchased SuzyQable from SparkFun. All right, so I have the commercial SparkFun SuzyQable here connected to the Google Pixelbook, also called Eve, and we'll see how it exposes itself. Is under the name Google Inc. CR50 as well as SuzyQable. And how we can interface with it is by connecting to one of the serial consoles. So I'm using the Pi serial package to connect to it. And if we connect to the CR50 shell, we'll see we have a connection to the CR50 shell, which is just fantastic. And we can communicate with this Google Eve. So let's switch over to our homemade cable and see how it does. So we notice this time if we LSUSB, we do not see the SuzyQable USB device, but that doesn't actually matter. We still see the CR50 USB device, and let's connect to it. So let's connect to the CR50 console. And through our homemade SuzyQable, we are able to connect to the CR50 console. As you can see, our homemade SuzyQable can also be used to read and write the spy flash just like the commercial one from SparkFun. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you do have any questions, please feel free to leave one in the comments below. Otherwise, have a nice day. Thank you.